What is good, YouTube? Quinn Wade, basketball analysis, coming to you with an analysis breakdown on Jason Tatum. He's an MVP, one of the most improved players because of his ability to get to the rim. He has the length, he has the size, he has the quickness, he has the IQ, he has the guys that can set good screens and help him get to the basket, but he can do it off the dribble by himself. As you can see, at the top of the key, he can see everything on the court. He's fast and he's quick enough and strong enough now because he bulked up and he's able to contort his body and finish strong and smartly, and he has good patience to make sure he has enough room to get the shot off without being contested by a center. And they have enough floor spacing on the court, as the Celtics have built a great roster around him, to where it's hard to double team or trap or have a shot blocker in the paint. And if you do, he's smart enough to use his body as a shield to create space to be able to get the layup off cleanly. And it's just a matter of putting in the work and being able to adjust. As you see, he goes straight at Giannis and he's able to finish using the backboard. So even if Giannis will block it, it will be a goaltend. So it still will be a bucket. And then he's so quick now because he worked on his fitness and worked on his body. He can get to the basket with will and strength now too. He used to be a little softer. He used to be a guy you can push around, but with the strength of bulking up, he's able to go strong even at Giannis and finish with force. And that was one of the best dunks of his entire career, just because he was fearless going to the basket and he was able to convert. As you just seen again, he's ready to go at anybody. His confidence is at an all-time high, and his bravado is what makes him great. His facilitating has improved. His ability to be a great scorer allows him to garner a lot of attention. A lot of teams double-team and trap him, as you see, leaving guys like Tatum, Derrick White, Al Horford, Marcus Smart open for easy opportunities. Things that they normally wouldn't get with Tatum back in the day, it would come mostly from Kyrie or Brown because they had the ability to penetrate. With Tatum's ability to hit the mid-range and the three and penetrate, it just creates more opportunities for the role players and the others on his roster to get open threes and open backdoor cuts all game. And it's something that made them a lot tougher to guard. And you can see even Al Horford, he's setting screens and he's getting open, and Tatum is willing to pass and find him because he's not a selfish player. Also, you can see that he has been working on his mid-range game. The fadeaway, perfect. He got the MJ Kobe fadeaway. He has the soft touch. He has the size to where it can be difficult to stop it, especially if he takes his time and set it up with the jab step to create the space. He has the length and the size to shoot over smaller defenders, like you've seen right there. He also has the handle to where he can get to where he wants to with the step and still hit it over smaller defenders with difficulty. The length and size doesn't bother him no more, as he has worked on his game to where even if you give him somebody physical with size, he can still shoot over them because he has the ability to get to his spot. And now he can even shoot it over centers because he gets there quicker. He knows how to shoot it. He knows the angle he needs to be at, and he can knock it down. He can knock down threes off the dribble. He has worked on his game. It's always been a part of his game, but he just gotten better at it. Just being able to make the contested ones just to get the shot off earlier has been something that he has worked on for multiple years, and now he's great. The thing I love about him mostly now is the spot-up shooting. Guys on this team can break down the defense like Brock Brogdon, like Derrick White, like Jaylen Brown, can get to the basket, and all he has to do is set his feet and knock it down. He can knock it down in transition too, whether it's open court transition as you see here, or is even, you know, spot up when contested somebody in his face. He has worked on that. Or even if it's catch and shoot with somebody penetrating, like I said before, he can set his feet, rotate his wrist, and knock it down with a lot of confidence. I also like the fact that his defense has stepped up. He can stay in front of guys. He's in passing lanes. He's going for steals more. He's hacking down at the ball and getting it cleanly stolen and stripping guys without fouling. He does get called for a little bit, but he's still improving that. I like the fact that he's giving more effort on the defensive end, especially after losing in the finals. He wants to be a great defender. I feel like he has gotten off to that start. It opens up easy opportunities for transition opportunities for the team, for them to get out and run if he gets a block or a steal. And I think that that just makes the team better, and it makes them more happier, and it makes them play with more energy. And I think that that becomes contagious, and it just makes the team better. Tatum is a great defender. He gets the steals. He gets the block. He stays in front of guys. He's a great communicator. There's nothing that he can't do offensively. He even got a little floater game in his game too, but he opts for the mid-range jumper now. He has the three-ball game. He has the finishing game, and he also can shoot free throws at an 80-plus percent clip. There's nothing that Tatum can't do. He can become the best offensive player. Only thing he's missing is consistency, and insecurities and immaturities need to be ironed out. As when you're a young player, you want to get away with a lot of things, and I feel like Coach Ime allowed him to do it. Mazzulla doesn't allow him to do it as much, and I feel like that made him a better teammate and a better player, and I just hope he continues to iron those things out so he can become one of the best players, if not the best player in the league, which he has already done this season. His game has changed. It has evolved. Because he wants to get better, he's willing to learn, and he's willing to do what's necessary to become as great as he wants to be. And I feel like as long as he has that mentality, he can be the best player in the league one day if he continues to put in the work.